from Knoxville, Tennessee. Welcome to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. Hi, wrestling fans. I'm Bob Caudle. This week we've got an action-packed hour in store for all you wrestling fans. We're going to see right here this week, Terry Bam Bam Gordy is going to be right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Hollywood Bob Holly also is going to be here. And we got a big, big main event with Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. What about that main event, Dutch Mantel?
Okay, the main event today, I want you, all you little munchkins, to listen up. Carl Stiles, my friend, is going to take that Brian Lee right in the ring today, and he's going to put an end to him because I'm going to see to it. I'm still a little bit under the weather, but I'm going to be in Carl Stiles' corner, and you people have seen the end of Brian Lee right here today.
Okay, fans, that's the main event we've been telling you about, Carl Stiles against primetime Brian Lee. And Dutch says he's going to be in the corner. This man right here, this man says he's the best conditioned athlete in all the professional sports. Rip Rogers, Rip.
First of all, I want to let all these hillbillies know that unlike these fat, disgusting, out of shape mountain folk, I'm the most fit man in all professional wrestling today. I can out-junk Michael Jordan. I can hit more home runs than Bobby Bonilla. I can do it all, baby, and I'm going to do it right today on TV, squats the whole hour.
He's going to do free squats, fan, during the entire hour, he says. And we'll be keeping tabs on that. Let's go to the ring now for a ring introduction.
This match will be one fall. Introducing first, weighing in at 223 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Jumping Joey Maggs.
Those Hollywood shades and all on, and here he is, Hollywood Bob Holly, as he makes his entrance into the ring.
Still undefeated in Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Weighing in at 229 pounds from Hollywood, California, Hollywood Bob Holly.
Dutch, you said a mouthful, and you're 100% right. No doubt about that. Here is a man that is undefeated on Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Hollywood Bob Holly. But I tell you, he's in against a tough one right here in Jumping Joey Maggs.
Bob Holly is undefeated here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and I predict today he will remain undefeated. Joey Maggs, a little bit inexperienced, probably quite not big enough. He's got youth on his side. He's got enthusiasm on his side. But he doesn't quite have the savvy and the experience of Hollywood Bob Holly. That's it in a nutshell. In other words, Bob Holly is just going to beat the tar out of him. I mean, I can't put it any more plainer than
well,
that.
Well, hey, and let me take a moment here.
Let me ask you something.
Okay.
Hustler Rip Rogers, he's going to do squats all through the...
He's right over here by, say he's going to do them the whole
How many have you done, Rip? 62 squats so far.
He's doing them, says he's going to do them the whole hour. Hey, let me mention, good, quick arm drag takedown right there by Maggs. Dutch, I want all of the fans to know that also during this hour we're going to have a ruling from Commissioner Barb Armstrong, and that's on Mr. Ron Wright, who has really been interfering. Every time we see him come into the arena, every time he gets down to the ring, he's been interfering in the matches, and Commissioner Bob Armstrong, he's going to make a ruling on that.
What kind of ruling?
I don't know, but he's got some news for us concerning Mr. Ron Wright.
Getting back to the match, fans, Joey Maggs is... As we look at him right now, he has Hollywood Bob Holly out of the ring. A lot of people think that's being scared, being a chicken. Well, it's not, because I can tell you from my many, many years of my wrestling that sometimes you step out of the ring like a batter steps out of a batter's box. You slow your opponent's momentum down.
Or if you're getting sick, you step out like you got sick on me last week.
Yes, I did get sick, and I didn't step out of the box. I would have been, but I was sick. I don't really feel that good today, but I feel good enough to manage Carl Stiles today in that match against the psychopath. I'm gonna save the FBI some trouble because we're gonna take him out today. He's a serial killer. We're gonna save the FBI a lot of trouble. We're gonna get rid of Brian Lee today so he can't go out and do bodily harm to any civilian out on the street.
I think Mag's right there surprised Hollywood Bob Holly with his quickness. Boy, he took that to Holly before he even knew what was happening to him. We talked about him being undefeated. That is Hollywood Bob Holly in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. His knees drop off of the top rope is one of the most devastating moves in wrestling, too. By the way, Dutch, look at this. Mag goes right under him. Scoop. scoop slam, power slam, drives him hard to the mat. Good arm drag takedown.
Well,
oh, Maggs, you got to be impressed with his quickness. That guy is quick.
Well, I am impressed. He's actually, I believe, what's going on right now. Joey Maggs is wrestling just a level above, really, what he's capable of doing, because he knows he's going to have to step it up just a notch to be able to stay with Bob Holly. Yes, Mr. Rogers, what is it? How much? 140 squats so far.
Well, Hustler Rip Rogers, he's still doing those free squats.
Huh? See, that's what I mean by experience.
Yes, sir. The experience paid right there.
Bob Holly grabbed that rope, and we see the end result of it. Joey Maggs jumping, Joey Maggs. Now, why do they call him jumping?
Well, that guy, you saw him get in the air, how high he can get in. He can really leap and he can really jump, but he got that blow right to the back of the head.
Why don't they call him leaping, Joey
Maggs? He may jump, he may jump higher than he leaps, Dutch. Oh, that leg drop. Holly got tight in the air with that one. He had all his weight behind that as Maggs was flat on the mat, only a count of two. You know, I can't wait to see Bam Bam Terry Gordy in action right here. That's going to be in our next match, Dutch.
Bam Bam Terry Gordy, for the Hermits who haven't heard of him, he's an international star, goes to Japan at least 30 weeks a year, doesn't really wrestle that much in the continental United States, and I think the fans here will be getting a treat when they see my good friend Bam Bam Terry Gordy show up out here.
Maggs almost pinned. Holly had him down for the count of two, using the ropes for a little extra power. Maggs comes off at big forearm right on the side of the head of Hollywood Bob Holly, and then Holly runs right into the foot to the midsection.
Oh!
Powerful right hand.
He rocked,
right on the mouth.
He rocked Holly on that one.
Back toss. Way high to the air goes Holly for that one. He took several big bounces when he hit that mat. Good shoulder block coming off of the ropes. Had him covered, couldn't hold him, didn't even get a one count on him. That shows you just how much stamina Holly has got.
Well,
that time he got a count of two before he kicked out.
If he can keep this up, he may stop Bob Holly's undefeated streak. Oh.
Well, he was set up to give him the back toss again. That time, experience factor again. Dutch, you talked about it earlier. As Hollywood Bob Holly came with a big elbow blow to the back of the neck. Watch out. Onto the top rope.
Well, now this
he's
is...
He's deadly with the elbows off of the top rope.
Whoa.
Look at that elbow drop. Way high to the air over the top rope. Covers him for the count of one, two, three.
Well, Bob Holly's under...
Well, that's Hollywood Bob Holly.
Well, Bob Holly's undefeated streak remains intact.
To with me right now, here is Tim Horner. Morristown, Tennessee's own Tim Horner. And Tim, all of the fans in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, they've just been delighted to see you and to have you in action.
That's right. You know, it's a pleasure to be...
Just a minute. 248, 249.
Hustler Rip Rogers, he's still doing his free squats over here.
Yeah. Well, like I said, it's a pleasure to be back in the Smoky Mountain.
Shut up! This is my interview time! 265, 256.
What?
Like I said...
Nobody wants to hear from a hillbilly.
Hey, have you got a problem?
I don't have a problem. I'm just doing free squats the whole hour to show everybody in TV land that I'm the most fit man in wrestling. You care to try?
I don't think you can do free squats for a whole hour, and I'm not even tired, like a bunch of you fat, disgusting mountaineer hillbillies.
You're gonna do it for an hour?
I'm gonna do this the whole hour, and there's nothing nobody can do about it.
I bet you anything that you can't do it. Wait a minute.
Hey, shut up!
Hey, I got $500 here. It says you can't do it the whole hour.
$500?
Yeah.
Well, that's stupid. If you want to throw away your money, because I can do squats for 3 weeks if I want to, and I'm going to prove it today on this program.
All right, that's on, fans. We're going to start it. We're going to see if he can last the entire hour, Tim. We'll keep track on him.
I'll be back later to see.
And fans, we'll be back. We'll have more right after this.
Fans, if you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match will be one fall. Weighing in 233 pounds from Washington, D.C., Tommy Angel.
All right, fans, right now, making his way to the ring, there's a founding member of the fabulous Freebirds, one of the biggest names in professional wrestling, Bam Bam, Terry Gordy.
Weighing in at 260 pounds, from Bad Street, Atlanta, GA, Terry Bam Bam Gordy.
All right, fans, Terry Bam Bam Gordy in a match here against Tommy Angel, and Angel, that's much the smaller of the two. Gordy, about over 260 pounds. He's going to have a tremendous weight advantage on Tommy Angel. Angel has really got to use his quickness and his speed, and if he can, move away and keep away from the big man.
It's not going to be enough. I don't care what he does. If he takes a parachute and jumps off the edge of the building, it's still not going to be enough, because Gordy would just jump at him, intercept him in the air, and take him all the way down to the ground and beat him up on the ground down there.
Well, I think
it's not going to be enough. Terry Gordy, as you mentioned just previous to what I'm saying right now, a founding member of the fabulous Freebirds, has been all over the world, an international star, doesn't wrestle that much in the United States, but I tell you, when he wrestles, the furniture is not safe. There's no telling where he might end up. I hope he doesn't come over here to the desk, because I am perfectly comfortable sitting right here and I don't want to be disturbed. But he may end up over here.
Angel now reverses and got Gordy in the corner now, brings him out with that headlock. We talked about him being a founding member of the fabulous Freebirds. You know, Dutch, they really revolutionized tag team wrestling, and Gordy is a champion many times over. You know, he's the highest paid American wrestler whenever he tours Japan.
Yes, he is. You know, like, when you talk about, like, musical groups, when you talk about the Beatles, to me, Paul McCartney was the Beatles. When you talk about Simon and Garfunkel, to me, Paul Simon was Simon and Garfunkel. When you talk about the Freebirds, to me, Terry Gordy was the Freebird. He was what made that team.
Well, to have such a big international star right here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, that tells you something about Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Hey, yeah, Hustler Rip Rogers, he's still over
467 squats. Did I mention that Carl Stiles is going to clean Brian Lee's clock in the main event on today's program? If anybody tuned in late, stay tuned, because I have been training and talking to Carl Stiles for a whole week, even though I'm sick and had to get off my deathbed to talk to him and train him. He is going to take Brian Lee today, and he's going to run him through the mill, and we're going to get rid of him. I'm getting tired of him running that big, fat mouth. I'm not afraid of anything, but I'm just getting sick and tired of hearing him run his mouth.
Gordy now with a headlock on Angel is backed into the corner as Angel backs him again to the turnbuckles. What kind of a break are we going to get? Look at that big sledgehammer blow from Gordy.
Uh-oh.
And then the foot to the midsection, and Gordy quickly on the attack again. What a knee lift.
Well, he just using Tommy Angel right now for target practice. He is really teeing off.
Now, Angel's a fine wrestler, but I'm not sure that he is. He may be just a little bit overmatched here, Dutch. Although I know he knew what he was getting into when he signed the contract for this match.
Well, if he doesn't step in the ring with these top guys, see, one of these days Tommy Angel is going to come up and he's going to upset a top name, and that's going to be the springboard for him to see if he can move up that ladder. Now, when he does upset somebody, say today, I don't think it ever, in 999 times out of 1,000, would he be able to beat Terry Gordy, unless Terry Gordy's as sick as I was last week. But say he beat Terry Gordy, then he'd be on his way up that ladder.
No doubt. You see,
after he would beat a top star like this, then it's up to him to see if he can beat another top star.
That was a devastating elbow right to the back of the head from Gordy, right on Tommy Angel. He's got Angel in bad shape now as he rolls him over and gets him covered, only for the count of two. Almost had a pin right there.
5:33, Dutch.
Well, and you hear Hustler Rip Rogers over here at our right. He's still doing those squats.
He's Gordy nearing the 550.
Front face. 550
squats.
How many do you think he's going to do in the whole hour if he lasts that long?
Well, I think he'd do probably 2,500.
Not a hillbilly
anywhere that can do that.
Well, we trade right hands. There's another big hard right from Angel now. He was going to whip Gordy across the ring. Gordy, too heavy for him, reversed it.
Oh, look out.
Watch out.
Power bomb.
The power bomb from Terry Bam Bam Gordy. And they don't.
Terry Bam Bam Gordy.
They don't get up from that power bomb, Dutch. Not when Bam Bam Terry Gordy puts it on you. And I tell you what, we can go watch it. Let's see it again right here.
Well, here's our first look at Terry Gordy here on Mountain Wrestling, and he puts the patented power bomb on Tommy Angel, takes him down, and I think what he's doing right now, he's just giving a little preview of what's to come for the other wrestlers here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and gets a big three count on Tommy Angel.
All right, fans, and right here, we're going to try to get big Terry Bam Bam Gordy over here with us. That was a great, great opening match here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and I know you're here because I know there's championship in the back of your mind, Smoky Mountain Heavyweight Championship, with a tournament coming up in the near future.
Let me speak truthfully to all these people here out here and everybody out there at TV. You know, I don't think there's a man alive that can beat me. I'd just like to say that right now. There is not a man alive today that can beat me. And you see what I did, the bombs are already starting to fall, Daddy. The bombs are falling. And it's just like this, Smoky Mountain Wrestling. If they've got a title, then it belongs to Terry Gordy. You can put your money on it. I know the commissioner, he's already got his money on it because he knows what Terry Gordy can do. I've done busted his head a couple of times, so you ask the commissioner what Terry Bam Bam Gordy can do. You know, Terry Gordy don't have no friends. And I'd just like to say this, I am the man that will hold that title if there is one.
Terry Bam Bam Gordy fans, we'll be back right after this. Wrestling fans, we want to invite you to continue watching each week right here on this station, Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Wrestling the way it used to be and wrestling the way you like it. The big news, of course, is that very soon, Smoky Mountain Wrestling will be coming live to your town. And you'll be seeing such outstanding stars as this man right here next to me, Nitro Danny Davis. Danny.
Thank you very much for the introduction. You know, I am proud to be associated with Smoky Mountain Wrestling because it's been a long time since I've been in the area. It's also been a long time since the wrestling fans around here have seen live wrestling. And it's like you said, there's nothing like live wrestling. So whenever Smoky Mountain Wrestling comes out, come out and see us. I'm looking forward to seeing all my friends from the past because for years, many years ago, I was the name here. Most fans remember me as Nightmare Danny Davis, but that's a thing in the past because now it's Nitro Danny Davis because just like a ball of nitroglycerin, you get too close and shake me up, I'm going to explode on you.
One of the many stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling fans, Nitro Danny Davis. Now let's talk with the commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Mr. Bob Armstrong. Bob?
Bob, it's good to be with you. I've got a list right here of some of the top wrestlers in the country and another list back here of some that negotiations are going on with as we speak. What Smoky Mountain is trying to do is bring the sport of wrestling back as a family feature, something you can bring your children out to enjoy and not be ashamed of at affordable prices. Some things have gotten out of context. I'm not going to allow any breakage of the rules, no pile drivers over the top ropes. You know all the things we've gone over. I've gone over it with the wrestlers, and fines are going to be handed out. Fines are going to be levied on anybody that breaks the rules. So we will try to make it a family affair, like I say. And like you've been talking about, it's much more fun to watch professional wrestling in person. TV matches are great, and we've had some great TV matches, good tournaments to come. But if you take my word for it, Smoky Mountain Wrestling is a place to be. Come out and see us when we come to your town, and come see us in person.
Fans, there he is, and still going strong, and he's been at it every minute. Hustler Rib Rogers still doing those squats. With me right now, Commissioner Bob Armstrong. Bob, I tell you, I know that we've been talking to a lot of them here. They got heavyweight championship on their mind.
You're exactly right, and there's good news. That heavyweight championship tournament is in the works, Bob. And it's my pleasure now to announce that in 2 weeks from tonight, we start the tag team title tournament. Some lucky team will win the newly sanctioned Smoky Mountain Tag Team Championship belt. So I'm looking forward to that, too. That ought to be great. We'll keep it going until somebody wins.
And that's going to start in 2 weeks right here on television,
right? In 2 weeks right here on TV, the Tag Team Smoky Mountain Tag Team Tournament. Now, that's the good news. Now, I've got some bad news, and I'm having a problem with Mr. Ron Wright.
Oh, yeah.
Now, we've got some film here, and I think if we go to that, maybe we can see some of the problems that I'm now having with Mr. Ron Wright.
Ground pull-off straight over the second rope, and he is now out here. And now there is Wright, is over to shake the hand of Koloff.
Shaking his hand, a good sportsmanlike gesture.
And Koloff with a right hand, he just about turned, he did. He turned the lights out. He turned Fulton's lights out with that right hand. Did Wright give him something outside of the ring?
Whipped him all the way across the ring.
Oh, big power slam.
boy, he had all of the power. When that guy gets you into the air about 6'7 or 6'8 high.
Hey, wait a minute. What did he give him?
Well, hey, I told you he wasn't going to come out.
He didn't give him anything.
He handed him something. Mantell's got something in his hand.
But Brian Lee blocked the punch. Brian Lee blocked it.
He's about to take it away from him.
Whoa, he nailed Dutch Mantell.
He's got him covered. Here comes referee Darryl Morris. 1-2. Oh, wait a minute.
Look at that.
He stopped.
He didn't take it off his hand. That stupid idiot Brian Lee did not take the knucks off his hand.
Oh, come on. Come on, what are you doing? He's going to rain on.
He's disqualified him.
Heck no, he can't do that. I don't believe him.
Wait a minute. Look, I hope Mr. Wright gets out all right.
He was about 8 or 9 feet up and came down hard to the mat off of that slam now.
Well, Bob Holly's undefeated record's at stake right here. He's in jeopardy.
Here's Angel now, out of the ring, down onto the apron. Hey, wait a minute. Look at this. Ron Wright has got him by the leg and the foot. Ron Wright is holding Angel.
No. Where?
He was holding him over there, Dutch. Over the ropes with a suplex comes Tommy Angel. And no doubt.
Commissioner, you're right. I've seen it. All the fans have seen it. He's been interfering in a number of matches.
That's exactly right. You know, a picture's worth a thousand words, and there you can see it. But you know, Ron Wright has got a manager's license, so my hands are tied. There's nothing I can do. But he's got no right to come down to the ring when either man in the ring is not under contract to Ron Wright. So for that, I'm telling Ron Wright right now, I am banning you from the ringside, brother. Unless you get a contract with somebody, I want you to stay away from the ring. It's not fair to the wrestlers. If you're wrestling somebody, you have to look at him. You don't want to be looking at Ron Wright. It's not fair to the fans who are watching for Ron Wright to pull something in front of missing some of the action in the ring.
Yeah.
So from now on, he is barred, Bob, and I do mean that.
Well, he can't. Wait a minute. Here is Mr. Ron Wright. And you heard that from the commissioner, I take it.
Listen, I'm hearing what you're saying, Mr. I can't believe that you'd come down here and try to mistreat a poor old crippled old man like me. You know, I've been one of the most finest upstanding gentleman wrestlers in my life. I've never harmed a man in my life in that ring. Here, I've got a bad hip, and I'm just trying to...
Just a minute, brother. You've gone to... I ain't gonna buy that garbage. Maybe some people you can feed that malarkey to, but you forget I know you, Ron Wright. I've been around you for more than 20 years. I've seen you wrestle. I've seen you take guys that are trying to get a start in this business and cripple them and mash them and maim them so bad that they couldn't even walk right. I got a scar in my head right now, and a knot on it that I'll have till the day I die. So you ain't fooling me. Now, I said that you're the rottenest, low-down, meanest wrestler that's ever been in the ring. And unless you get a contract with somebody, I said you're barred from this, and you are barred right now. You keep your manager's license, but keep your butt away from that ring.
Let me tell you something, Bob Armstrong. If
you
I
ain't telling me nothing.
Man, I was. I'd get up if I had let somebody me, to pick me up out of this.
Oh, fans. Hey, there goes Mr. Ron Wright, fans.
Fans, with me right now is Mr. Jerry Williams, the principal of Morristown, Tennessee's East High School. And Jerry, recently you had a Smoky Mountain event in your school.
Bob, yes, we did. Had a great turnout of fans. I'll tell you what, Smoky Mountain Wrestling brought top-notch wrestlers into the area. We had a great time, and I tell you, these people are easy to work with, and I'd recommend they bring them to their school if they need to raise some funds. The East High baseball team is taking advantage of this situation.
Fans, you can get all the information by writing to the address on your screen right now about Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Fans, with me right now, world-renowned Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Paul, already, the Smoky Mountain Tournament, the word is getting around, and they're coming from all corners, and I know you're interested in that championship also.
Well, that's very true, you know, but still, I've been researching this thing a little bit more, that I can't use a pile driver. Well, I just saw Bam Bam, what's his name out there, just do a move that could have broke somebody's neck. I saw a drop kick off the top rope that could have broke somebody's neck. And here's another guy that uses a neck breaker that could have broke somebody's neck. But Mr. Wonderful can't go out there and use a move that is known through all out the world, and that's the pile driver. I want to know why, and the people out there want to know why, that I can't use my pile driver when everybody else can use what they want to use. What's the deal down here,
Commissioner
brother?
Commissioner Bob Armstrong has ruled it illegal, and you know, and I think all the wrestling fan knows, what a deadly move that is, Paul.
Well, let's face it, we're out here to win. I mean, we're not a bunch of little babies out here. I'm out here to win. You got Bam Bam up here running his mouth that there ain't a man out here that can beat him. Well, you know, I think the same way. I don't think there's a man out here that can beat me. But you know what, Mr. Wonderful's different. I don't need to use the pile driver. I got a lot of other moves that I can beat people with.
All right, we're going to watch him in action, fans. Here he is, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff. Let's go to the ring.
This match will be one fall. Introducing first, weighing in at 229 pounds, from St. Petersburg, Florida, Bad Boy Barry Horowitz. Weighing in at 250 pounds, from Atlanta, Georgia, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Boy, everybody's fired up today, aren't they, Mr. Cottle?
I tell you, Dutch, everybody is really fired up, and you can't blame them either with so much on the line. And we're talking about the heavyweight championship. And by the way, you know, that championship will be coming up in the near future. And I think we're going to have some word.
Tag team tournament starting in 2 weeks
on
television.
Tag team tournament
and
in 2 weeks.
And a single tournament to follow shortly thereafter, I'm sure. Correct? Now, today we've had two men throw their names into the hat. Bam Bam Terry Gordy and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, and both of them said the same thing. Both of them said they ain't a man alive that can beat them.
Well, boy, I tell you, that's like two irresistible forces going to come together. Orndorff back to the corner by Horowitz. Horowitz is a big one. He's an experienced individual. Horowitz got a lot going for him in there, Dutch.
Well, let me ask you this.
He's got good size. He's got good quickness and speed. He knows wrestling.
Oh, yeah, well, I know all that stuff. Now all the fans know all that stuff. I need to get to the nitty-gritty. Inquiring minds want to know, why is the pile driver famous? Do you know?
Why? No, I don't. Because
do you know?
I don't have the exact words from the commissioner. All I know is that it's a very deadly move. You can really seriously injure, or you can really maim someone, kill someone with that pile driver, Dutch. And that probably, the commissioner did not tell me why, but I am assuming that that is the reason. And you know, and I think everybody that watches wrestling knows just how deadly that move can be.
Well, see, Paul Orndorff, it does hamper his style, and I'm not a great friend of Orndorff's, of course, you know, because he's a little overbearing at times and obnoxious, but he has a point. Well, when you take a man's signature move away from him,
yeah,
which is the pile driver, you
look
sort
at this
of...
bridge. Look at Orndorff. Boy, you're talking about strength and power. Look at that, Dutch. Is he in shape or is he in shape?
He's in shape.
Yes, sirree.
You can say that again.
I'm telling
you.
He's
in shape.
He definitely is that. You know, yeah, I tell you.
I have just been informed.
He's still doing them.
I've just been informed by Hustler Rip Rogers, 1,060 squats.
Oh, man. You know, talking about Orndorff again, he's made it plain he wants that title. He doesn't think anybody can beat him. And as you say, he has begun to question about the pile driver and why it's illegal. How much do you think that's going to hamper him if he can't use his favorite hold?
Well, I think the pile driver should be legal.
Hey, I think you think knives and guns ought to be legal, Dutch. As far as I know, that's exactly the way you'd think about
knives
it.
Knives and guns are legal.
Not in the ring, they're not.
Well, no.
Only in war.
Oh, I guess you're some kind of General Schwarzkopf or something now, I guess.
I thought you was going to tell me that you have got war, and that's a war in the ring. And
well, there's going to be a war when Carl Stiles gets in the ring a little later on today's program against Brian Lee. There's going to be a war, and Brian Lee's not going to win it.
Well, that match is coming up, fans, and of course, that's our big main event. That
big,
was a good fireman take.
Big, loud mouth, muscle here.
Orndorff now on his feet. He's got the leverage advantage right here as he's got the pressure on Horowitz.
Has Horowitz won a match here yet?
Has Horowitz won a match? Certainly Horowitz has won matches.
Has he won here in Smoky Mountain Wrestling?
I don't think so. I don't think so, Dutch. I don't recall.
No, I don't think he's won a match
yet. But an athlete that good, one is as good as he is. Look at that knee. High into the air. He got that knee right up beside the head of Orndorff, and Orndorff went flying through the ropes off the apron, hard down onto the floor.
He knocked him completely. Yeah, there you go, man. Barry. Pat yourself on the back.
But
good
a guy,
job.
You know, a guy with the ability that Horowitz has got, hey, he's got to come up with a lot of wins. Look at that knee again. He's going to take him right over to the ring, roll him back in. I thought he was going to try to get into cover. Oh, watch out neck. Ooh, my heavens.
Well, now, if the pile driver is illegal,
wow,
why is that legal?
Gracious.
You could seriously injure somebody with that across the voice box.
Oh,
with an elbow across the voice box.
Orndorff caught a couple of them. Watch out, he's going to do it. Well, here's the rope. Again, under the rope. And again, right down across the throat in the voice box, as you said.
Yep.
Dutch. Boy, Orndorff. He's in trouble now.
I wish you'd do that to Brian Lee so I couldn't hear his voice, couldn't hear him talking. You know, to the fans out there who don't know a lot about Brian Lee, he's a no good son of a gun. I'm going to tell them that right now. He hates kids. He hates animals. He doesn't even like Baskin-Robbins ice cream. Something's wrong with him.
Well, Horowitz has got Mr. Wonderful in trouble now, and he's staying right on top of him.
Gut-wrench suplex.
Oh, man. He had a lot of power behind that.
And a good one, too.
Had him covered, had the leg.
You see him, he's cinching that leg up. Horowitz is trying for this pin. He knows if he can get a win over Orndorff, that'd be an honor.
Hey, Dutchie's got him stacked now for the count of two. Oh, almost a count of three. Orndorff just escaped it in the nick of time.
Well, that wasn't a pinning combination. I saw the company. It was too slow developing.
Turning in now with that front face as they're down on their knees, and Horowitz still now putting the pressure. He's staying right around that throat.
Right, he's got good strategy because he worked on his voice box outside. We were just talking about it. Now he's trying to cut his wind off is what he's trying to do.
Well, bad boy Barry Horowitz, and he came by that name naturally because he is certainly that in the ring. That was the elbow all the way across the ring. Now comes Orndorff. Oh, Orndorff, high in the air, got the knee right up into the jaw, and that just cut Horowitz a backward flip. Clothesline coming out of that corner.
Well, Orndorff must have had his second win now.
There goes Horowitz through the ropes and out of the ring. Orndorff's going to go out after him.
Well, he felt that one downtown.
Now they're out of the ring, down on the floor. There's that steel cage around the ring, and Horowitz hits it hard.
A lot of similarity between Bam Bam, Bam Bam Terry Gordy, and Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Would that be some clash, or would that be a clash?
Well, see, both of them are brawlers. Both of them are they'll take it outside of the ring.
Boy, you
Bam Bam Gordy in his match, he was tame compared to what he usually is.
Orndorff now up onto the top rope. Horowitz reeling around in the center of the ring, and that big elbow high off of the top rope. Very quickly, he's back to the
end. He's going for
the pile driver, and the referee's telling him no.
See, he had him set
for it.
Now, he had him beat right there, but the pile driver is illegal, and the referee would not let him do it.
And he missed that drop kick.
See, he has depended on that move for so long because he is the master. He is the master of the pile driver. A lot of guys have always done it, but nobody did it more effectively than did Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Horowitz high with a knee drop. Had him down, had the leg hooked, had the count of two on him.
Actually,
well, Dutch, you're right. No doubt Orndorff would have put him away right there with a pile driver. Now Horowitz stomping on the fingers.
Horowitz is living on borrowed time right now.
Back row. Can he hold him? Yes, sirree. Well, he proved to you that he has more than one move and one way to defeat a man.
Good. Paul Orndorff.
That was a good win. A good win by Paul Orndorff right there. You see, he started with the pile driver, and the referee would not let him do it. So what he did, he turned him around, got behind him with a go-behind cradle right there, and got the pin on him, which just goes to show us Paul Orndorff has more in his arsenal than just the pile driver.
All right, fans, and there he is, and he's still doing those squats. Hustler Rip Rogers, he says he's going to do them for the entire hour, and we'll be back right after this.
Fans, if you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
All right, fans, in 2 weeks, it's a big tag team tournament. Jim Cornette,
why the big mystery
about the team?
First of all, if you look over here at the front row, they've decided to remake Deliverance with the original cast. I want you people to shut up while I'm doing something out here. Let me tell you something. Mr. Stick His Nose at Everybody's Business Armstrong, he assaults a cripple over here. He tells me, shut up. He tells me, Jim Cornette, it's not fair for you to have a mystery team in a tournament. It's not fair for all the other teams not to know who it is. Well, let me tell you something. If I was to reveal the identity of my tag team, then every single man in this part of the country would hang his head in shame, move out of the area. It would create financial upheaval, socioeconomic calamity. The whole area, the whole way of life as we know it would be thrown into disrepair. And as far as the tournament goes, the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Tournament would be decimated. Every wrestler would be diving out of it. They'd be so scared. But I will say one thing. My team is sexier than Madonna's last video, built better than a bomb shelter, and more dangerous than a dinner party at Jeffrey Dahmer's place. And they will be the tag team champions. Good luck, Rip.
All right, and Rip Rogers is still at it. Jim Cornette, Dutch Mantel. Last week, Carl, you were supposed to wrestle. Carl Stiles, you had Carl go in and do your dirty work for you. Fans, let's go back and look at some of that, what happened.
Stiles. Good. Oh, he did a great job. I'm so dadgum sick.
Wait a minute. Oh. What is this right here? Who is this? Here he is.
Carl Stiles, I have no problem with you. I believe you've been made a fool of by Dutch Mantel. Dutch Mantel, if you have one gun in your body, you'll get in this ring and we'll finish it right here, right now.
Wait a minute. I am sick. I'm sick. I got a fever. I got a fever and I can't get...
Oh,
come on, Carl!
Style.
Beat him up!
Yes,
come on, Carl! Come on! Get on him, Carl!
Let him go.
Carl's
going
to beat him up
left
for me!
Right.
So, come on, Carl! Come on, get him down! Get him down, Carl! If I ever saw a coward, it's in the form of Brian Lee. Now, coming up next, people, we're going to take a two-minute break. But coming up next, Brian Lee, he's going to drag his low-life, egg-sucking carcass right down that aisle. He's going to climb in that ring with my man right here, Carl Stiles, and it's going to be a historical happening. Just in 2 minutes, we're going to take Brian Lee out.
Fans, if you'd like to raise money for your school, club, or civic organization, and you'd like to see the excitement of Smoky Mountain Wrestling live in your hometown, this message is for you. High school and college athletic departments, sports teams, police and fire departments, JCs, civic groups, or any group wishing to raise money can bring the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling to town for a night of action and receive a portion of the receipt. Write to us or call Sandy Scott at 703-989-6819. Smoky Mountain Wrestling and your civic group, an unbeatable tag team.
All right, fans, having joined me right now here, Jim Cornette.
Keep going, Rip. I know you can do it, baby. Look at those legs. Haven't seen legs like that since Florence Griffith Joyner.
He's been going since the opening bell, fans. Let's go to the ring.
He's been going since he was 5 years old.
Ladies and gentlemen, this match will be one fall. Introducing first, weighing in 274 pounds from Murphy, North Carolina, Carl Stiles. He is accompanied by Dirty Dutch Mantel.
All right, fans, and here he comes now, making his way toward the ring, the opponent, and I think Dutch Mantel is...
Wait a minute!
Brian Lee.
Brian Lee's going after Dutch Mantel. Looks like the Keystone Cops. Here they go around the ring.
And Stiles is behind.
Stiles is behind, but he's way behind. He's got Dutch Mantel.
Hey, you can't blame him. He's been warning Dutch, and last week Dutch bailed out on him.
I can't believe Brian Lee attacking an innocent man, somebody that's not even involved in the match. There's ring announcer Marvelous Mark Aston trying to get out of here. Brian Lee's coming up behind Dutch Mantel again. Where's Stiles?
He wants Dutch Mantel. He's not caring about Stiles right now.
This place is a madhouse. They're going nuts. As soon as one guy chases one guy catches another guy.
Hey, Lee's going to be caught between them now. Look from behind. Stiles got him from behind. Look at that big blow right to the back of the head. Rolls him into the ring. Now Stiles in there.
Wait a minute. Now look at Brian Lee. Unsportsmanlike conduct on Carl Stiles. Didn't even let him get back in the ring. I tell you what, Brian Lee is so preoccupied with Dutch Mantel, he's not paying attention to his opponent. Here he goes again.
Well, he goes out of the ring again. He sent Stiles high to the air with that backdrop all the way across, and out of the ring again goes Mantel, and he's having a hard time just staying away from Lee. But right there to meet him was Stiles again. Hey, you know, this could really cost Brian Lee. Jim, he doesn't have his mind on what he's doing, and he better worry about Stiles.
I tell you something, Brian Lee doesn't have his mind on Carl Stiles. He doesn't have his mind on the Smoky Mountain Wrestling Heavyweight Championship Tournament. There's going to be guys like Terry Gordy, Paul Orndorff, Jimmy Golden, Ivan Koloff, all vying
for the Smoky Mountain title, and Brian Lee, all he can think about is Dutch Mantell.
Well, and that could be a big mistake, but we're going to enter Mantell in a track meet if he continues to run around the ring like he's been going. That guy's showing you how quick he is out there on his feet.
He did the 4.540 at Oil Trough High in Oil Trough, Texas.
All right, and back into the ring again, out near the center of the ring as they stand toe-to-toe, and that was prime time Brian Lee with that big blow right to the midsection. But look at Styles. He may get him up for the suplex. He's trying to get him into a position for it. Looked like Lee blocked it.
Lee squatted a little bit.
There he goes. He reversed it on him. High in the air with that suplex.
Jim, wait a minute. Here he goes,
What the heck? You talked about that tournament and that heavyweight championship tournament. Let's remind all the fans again, right here in 2 weeks on TV, our tag team tournament gets underway.
And Brian again, Lee's closing in on Dutch Mantell. Here comes it. Brian Lee is just so single-minded. He is so angry. And Dutch Mantell, he can't keep his mind on anything else, but Carl Stiles now punishing him outside the ring. This thing is just a madhouse.
Every time he catches up with Dutch Mantell, right behind him comes Stiles, and Lee pays for it. Now, they're back into the ring as Stiles rolls back in under his Brian Lee right in, Mantell now outside of the ring.
Sends him off reversal. Wait a minute, Stiles went to backdrop him, but Brian Lee just sidestepped and kicked him right in the head.
He saw that one coming, and that was the big boot to the head. Look at that big right hand. What a powerful move again to the side of the head. Scoops him up for that power slam, and he powered him hard to the mat.
Wait a minute, here he comes again.
Dutch
Mantell got him right in the eyes. He came out after Mantell, but Mantell got him right in the eyes.
Lee better keep his mind on what's going on in the ring.
Hey, let me tell you something. If Brian Lee gets eliminated here, that's a big threat in the heavyweight title tournament. And as far as I'm concerned, I like to see threats in these tournaments eradicated. But the biggest threat of all,
Dutch Mantell. Mantell's got him draped across that apron. He just kept driving those right hands and then ripped and clawed at the face.
The biggest threat of all in a tournament, Bob Caudle, is coming up in 2 weeks here on television. The tag team tournament begins. It's going to last a period of weeks. But my team will be unveiled in that tournament, and they will win it and be the Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions.
I think you're trying to pull some kind of a surprise on everybody by not naming that team and not telling who they are.
I'm being charitable. It would destroy the way of life as we know it in this part of the country if all the men moved out, because they'd be so ashamed at the sight of real men for once.
There's Mantell on Lee again as Lee's underneath the ropes. Primetime Brian Lee. Boy, he has really paid. This has cost him dearly in this match, the way he has stayed after Dutch Mantell. I don't think Mantell shouldn't even be down there in the first place, Jim.
Dutch Mantell is guiding Carl Stiles. He is guiding his career. He's helping the man to become a great professional wrestler. There's nothing wrong with that.
Well, Stiles with a slam now on Lee. Came with an elbow drop and the chin.
I don't know why Bob Armstrong sticks his nose in my business, in Dutch Mantell's business, in Ron Wright's business. He wants to know the identity of my tag team. So does everybody else. He wants to know just exactly who Ron Wright is going to sign up, if anyone.
Trying to
ban him from ringside.
He wants Ron Wright to keep from interfering down there at ringside like he's been
doing.
He's
not interfering. He's scouting. And as far as my tag team is concerned, there is no way that I'm going to reveal it could cause panic and chaos everywhere. Brother, this is going to be the biggest thing of all time.
You probably think the pile driver shouldn't be outlawed also. Is that right?
I think that the pile driver is a very dangerous hold in the hands of Paul Orndorff. But there's a lot of other dangerous holes, and I'm on Orndorff's side in this thing, believe it or not. I think it should be legal. What about Brian Lee's cancellation?
Yeah.
You could break a man's back with that. That ought to be illegal.
All right, primetime Brian Lee got the elbow right into the midsection. Coming off of the ropes. Caught him in the bear hug. Got him up off of the mat. Jim, look at the power he's got around that waist and around that chest, those tremendous arms, shoulders, and muscles.
Well, Carl Stiles is probably the only guy I know that could pick primetime Brian Lee up like that and shake him around like a rag doll, because Brian Lee is a big, solid young man.
Well, Stiles is 274 pounds. That's pretty big, too. And right now, look at the referee checking the arm. That pressure really beginning to tell on primetime Brian Lee. It's going to break it.
Brian Lee, a big boot to the midsection. He is fighting back, but Stiles goes to the eyes again. You can't get on an eye machine at the gym. There's no way to train the eyes.
Sirree, boy, when you go to the eyes, that's a big equalizer. There's that big foot coming off the ropes. Primetime Brian Lee got the foot right up into the chest. Now look at him to the attack with that big right hand. He's going to whip him off the ropes with that Irish whip across.
Whoa!
What a clothesline!
Oh, he took him out of his boots. Did you hear that flesh smack?
Is that head still on his shoulders? My heavens, what a blow.
Don't worry, you can't hurt Stiles by hitting him in the head. Wait a minute.
He's going for the cancellation.
Yeah, he turned it into a power bomb himself.
Here comes Mantell, but it's too late. Look at him go to work. Brian Lee's the winner, but look at Mantell. Mantell now.
Brian Lee went for the cancellation. Styles, 280 pounds, couldn't quite maneuver him, but he got him in the powerbomb for the pin. But now, Mantell and Styles, double clothesline, he missed it.
Lee coming off with a double clothesline, and they both go down. Look at him right back up on Styles again.
Wait a minute, Lee's got his hands on Dutch Mantell. This could be the end for Dutch. Wait a minute, fans.
There he is, primetime Brian Lee.
We got to get this thing cleared up. Let's get out.
All right, fans, let's go. We'll be back. We'll have more. Don't go away. Right now, let's take time out for this.
Wrestling fans, remember, for the best in action and excitement, be sure you watch each week right here on this station for Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Wrestling the way it used to be. Wrestling the way you like it. A number of outstanding stars, and we'll be letting you meet one of them in just a moment. In addition, we've also have tremendous and great managers. One of them right here, Jim Cornette.
Are you trying to insinuate I'm not a tremendous and great star? We'll meet one of them in a minute, but first, here's Jim Cornette. Let me tell you something. You know we're coming back with live professional wrestling in all the towns in the Smoky Mountain Wrestling area. You know what that's like? An albatross. That's a big, ugly bird that hangs around your neck, bringing doom and destruction everywhere it goes. That's what going to these redneck hillbilly towns is to me, an albatross. I'm calling Bob Armstrong. I ain't going to these stinking towns.
Speaking of stars, fans, one of the greatest ever in professional wrestling right here, and here he is. All the wrestling fans around the country know this man, Terry Bam Bam Gordy.
Well, Terry, that's right. You know, it's like this. I've been from Freebird Mountain all around the world. I've been from Freebird Mountain to Tokyo, Japan. I've been from Freebird Mountain, like I said, all around the world, but this is the first time I ever came from Freebird Mountain to the Smoky Mountains. Right here I am. I'm ready to take. The bombs are starting to fall. Can you hear? Get out! Get out! Get out! Get out! The bombs are starting to fall. And I'm going to be the one that drops the biggest bomb of all right there in your town, wherever the Smoky Mountain Wrestling goes. And I'll guarantee you this, the skies over your town is going to be illuminated.
Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and don't forget, it's going to be coming live soon to your town. Great news for all you wrestling fans, live professional wrestling, Smoky Mountain Wrestling, will be coming to your area very soon. You've been asking for it, you've been wanting it, and Smoky Mountain Wrestling is going to deliver it. And one of the guys that's going to be kicking up a lot of dust, no doubt about that, the Louisville Slugger himself, Jim Cornette.
Yeah, all the dust is going to come out of your pocket. That's how often you reach in that wallet. You know, all over the area, they're making plans to come see Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Over there in Tennessee, they're taking a couple of swigs of that white light and that moonshine. Take in a few deposit bottles, get some pocket change, come out and see it. Over in West Virginia, they're coming up out of holes in the ground, belching out some coal dust. Hey, take a swig of that Formula 44 to keep that black lung down. Come out and see some wrestling. All over the place. Everybody wants to see professional wrestling again. They don't want to see a circus. They don't want to see a sideshow. They want to see somebody get in there and fight and scratch and kick and gouge. And the only way they're going to win that match is if they got more guts in their belly than the guy they're standing across the ring from. Well, that's exactly what's going to happen with Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And when my tag team comes to town, brother, and they'll be revealed real soon, you can be assured of one thing and one thing only. Jim Cornette gets his way. When I tell you something's going to happen, brother, it's going to happen. If I tell you the sun ain't going to come up tomorrow, you better go out and buy you a flashlight. And I'm saying my tag team is going to reign supreme in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. All you rednecks, you hillbillies, you genetic defects, come on out and take a look at it.
Fans, it's Smoky Mountain Wrestling. It's wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. Be sure to look for it.
Tim, Rip Rogers still at it. Looks like he's going to make it.
Well, I figure a man's good as his word. If he finishes up, I'm going to pay him.
That's right,
Bob.
I'm going to spend all your money and there's nothing you can do about it.
What?
I said I'm going to spend all your money and there's nothing you can do about it. That's what I said.
How much time's he got left, Bob?
Let me check that. Let me check this watch. Hold on, Tim. $59.30. Rip, you didn't make it.
What do you mean I didn't make it?
See you next week, Bob.
2,601, 2,602, 2,600. Get the camera on me, everybody.
No, you didn't make it. Fans, that's going to do it. See you next week.
2,612, 2,618.